Welcome to ExamBee once again. So in this video, we will discuss some basics of agriculture which will be helpful for your preparation in phase 2 of NABARD grade A agriculture and rural development section. So after this video, we will release some videos of agronomy, then animal husbandry, then horticulture, and we will cover all the relevant and important topics in the upcoming days for your preparation of phase 2 NABARD exam. So let's start with some basic things. So in agriculture, there are three seasons, Kharif, Rabi and Zayad. This term Kharif, Kharif means autumn. So in Arabic, Kharif means autumn or rainy season. This Kharif season, it starts from June, July and it ends in October. Means crops of Kharif season, these are sown in June, July and these are harvested in October. Crops of this season are also known as monsoon crops because these crops are sown or these crops are grown with the help of southwest monsoon. So with the beginning of southwest monsoon, that is in the month of June, July, these crops are sown. So these crops are also known as monsoon crops. The common examples of these crops are paddy, maize, soybean, sorghum, groundnut, cotton, and some kharif pulses. Then Rabi season. Rabi is also an Arabic term, which means spring. So Rabi crops are sown in the month of October, means after the harvest of Kharif crops, and these crops are facilitated by northwest monsoon. And these crops are harvested in the month of February. There are three seasons. First season, that is Kharif. It starts from July and ends up to October. Then we have Rabi. It starts from October, then ends up to February. Then we have Zayad. Zayad starts from February, March and ends in May. So this is a cycle of seasons, Kharif, Rabi and Maize. The agriculture year in India starts from July and ends in June. So this might be a question in the exam. From which month agriculture year starts? So it will be July. The cycle is July to June. For financial year, it is April to March. So crops of Rabi season are also known as winter crops since these are grown in winter season. And examples of Rabi crops are wheat, chickpea, field pea or garden pea, sunflower, safflower, mustard, etc. Potato is also sown in Rabi season. Then Zayad. Zayad in Arabic means summer. So Zayad crops are sown in March and harvested in month of May. These are also known as summer crops. And the most common examples of Zayad are cucurbits. Cucurbits means the members of family Cucurbitaceae, like all the melons and gourds. Then some pulses like moong, groundnut. Then sunflower and maize can also be grown in Zayad season, and summer rice or paddy is grown in Zayad season. Let's move forward. So there are two basic terms. This kind of a question might be asked in the exam. So we must know that there are two terms, agriculture and agronomy. So this term agriculture, it is derived from Latin language, and term agronomy is derived from Greek language. So only these two things are important. Any word which ends with culture will be of Latin language, or any word which ends with nomi will be of Greek language. Then production and export in India. So such a question was asked in the phase 1 exam this year too. In this slide, we will discuss both quantity wise and value wise. So quantity wise, we have cereals at the first position, then fresh fruits and vegetables, then other processed fruits, foods, then animal products, and then processed foods and vegetables. So in case we have to make a series of in descending order, the highest quantity exported from India is of cereals, which is followed by fresh fruits and vegetables, other processed foods, animal products, and processed fruits and vegetables. So among these, among cereals, the highest quantity exported is of non-basmati rice. So highest quantity exported from India among cereals is of non-basmati rice, then basmati rice, then wheat, and then maize. So here we can put a descending order symbol. Likewise, in case of fresh fruits and vegetables, the highest quantity exported is of onion, then other fruit fresh vegetables, then other fresh fruits, then grapes, and then mangoes. In case of processed foods, maximum export is of guar gum, then groundnut, then milled products, and then alcoholic beverages. In case of animals, बफेलो मीट, पोल्ट्री प्रोडक्ट्स, डेयरी प्रोडक्ट्स, नेचुरल हनी, शीप गोट मीट. सो मैनी क्वेश्चंस कैन बी एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम दिस स्लाइड इटसेल्फ. देन इन केस ऑफ प्रोसेस्ड फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स, मैक्सिमम क्वांटिटी इज प्रोसेस्ड फ्रूट्स, देन जूसेस एंड नट्स, देन पल्सेस एंड देन प्रोसेस्ड वेजिटेबल्स. सो सिमिलरली दिस वॉज द केस ऑफ क्वांटिटी, वी हैव ऑल्सो अरेंज्ड ऑल दिस आइटम्स ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स इन द डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर विथ देयर वैल्यू. सो इन केस ऑफ वैल्यू, हाइएस्ट वैल्यू एक्सपोर्टेड इज ऑफ सीरियल्स, देन एनिमल प्रोडक्ट्स, देन अदर प्रोसेस्ड फूड्स, देन फ्रेश फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स, एंड देन प्रोसेस्ड फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स. स्लाइड वॉज अबाउट प्रोडक्शन एंड एक्सपोर्ट. इन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड वी हैव सीन एक्सपोर्ट, एंड नाउ वी विल डिस्कस प्रोडक्शन. सो फूड ग्रेन प्रोडक्शन, अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस वॉज आस्क्ड इन आवर फेज वन एग्जाम दिस ईयर टू. वट इज द फूड ग्रेन प्रोडक्शन इन द खरीफ सीजन अकॉर्डिंग टू फर्स्ट एडवांस एस्टिमेट्स. सो क्वेश्चन वॉज फ्रॉम दिस फिगर 140.6. सो इन दिस स्लाइड एंड द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वी विल डिस्कस द प्रोडक्शन डेटा ऑफ इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द फाइनल डेटा ऑफ 2017-18, द टोटल प्रोडक्शन इज 285.01 मिलियन टन्स. अकॉर्डिंग टू फोर्थ एडवांस एस्टिमेट्स ऑफ 2018-19, फाइनल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ 2018-19 इज 284.95. दिस इज ऑलमोस्ट इक्वल टू 285 मिलियन टन्स, विच इज सिमिलर टू लास्ट ईयर. एंड फॉर 1920 द टारगेट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इज टू डू अ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ 291.10 मिलियन टन्स. देन इन केस ऑफ कोर सीरियल्स, टोटल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ 2017-18 इज 47 मिलियन टन्स. फॉर 2018-19 इट इज 43 मिलियन टन्स, विच इज 4 मिलियन टन लेसर देन द प्रीवियस ईयर. फॉर द ईयर ऑफ 2019-20 द टारगेट इज 48.3 मिलियन टन्स. फॉर सीरियल्स द टारगेट इज 264.8, और यू कैन से 265 मिलियन टन्स फॉर द ईयर ऑफ 2019-20. And in the 18-19, it was 261.6 million tons. For pulses, the target is 26.30 million tons. So in case of oil seeds, it is not million tons, it is lakh tons. So this will be 36.10 million tons. We can say this is 36.10 million tons. So sometimes question is asked like, arrange the following in order of their total production in India. And your options will be pulses, cereals, oil seeds, coarse cereals and food grains. So you have to arrange all of them according to their production in India. So you can take the screenshots or make your own notes of this. Students enrolled in ExamBee course will get PDF notes of all these slides in their course itself. Then India's position in world agriculture. Sometimes this becomes important. So I'm not going to recite all these one by one. You can click on the screenshot. Like in case of pulses, India is the leader. In case of jute, India is the leader. In case of buffaloes and milk production, India is the leader. In most of the other things, India is second, following China. In case of meat production, India is sixth. So there are many national and international days. Out of them, the most important ones I have written here. National Farmers Day is celebrated on 23rd December. National Woman Farmers Day is celebrated on 15th October. World Food Day is celebrated on 16 October. This is also the foundation day of FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, which has its headquarters in Rome, Italy. Then ICR Day, the day on which ICR was established. It is on 16th July. The National Agriculture Day, it is celebrated on 1st July. Then National Agriculture Day and National Farmers Day are different. Then Panchayati Raj Day, this has been asked several times in the exam. That's why I have put it here. It is 24th April. Then World Soil Day is celebrated on 5th December. This is important. Then origin of some main crops. So rice and sugarcane are originated from Southeast Asia, and wheat and barley are originated from Southwest Asia. Other than this, tobacco and maize are important, and sunflower is originated from USA. Let's move forward. National and international years. So this is again very important. These national and international years, here in this slide we are discussing all the international years, and these international years are according to what UNO has declared. So UNO declared these years as I have written here. 2015 was National Year of Soil, 16 was National Year of Pulses, 17 was for Sustainable Tourism Development, 19 was International Year of Indigenous Languages, 2020, this year, it is the year of International Year of Plant Health. Then 2021 will be the year of fruits and vegetables. 2022 will be year of fisheries and aquaculture. And 2023, it is declared as the International Year of Millets. This question was asked in the phase 1 exam of NABARD graded this year itself. Then some important operations in main crops. Since one question was asked from this in the phase 1 exam, so this becomes important. So we will discuss some more important operations of some other crops. So rabbing is done in tobacco, stalking is done in tomato, topping is for cotton, desuckering is for tobacco, propping is in banana and sugarcane. Propping is basically providing support. Similarly, stalking is also providing support. Denevelling is cutting the female part or the flower of banana. It is in banana. Wrapping is in sugarcane, binding many sugarcane plants so that they are saved from falling down in heavy winds. Then nipping is done in gram. Curing is an operation of both tobacco and tea. Let's move forward. There are some important agencies related to agriculture in India. First one is NAFED. So NAFED is National Agriculture Cooperative Marketing Federation. It is an apex organization which is responsible for marketing of agriculture produce in India. It is under Ministry of Agriculture, Government of India. It was established on 2nd October 1958. Then we have APEDA. APEDA is responsible for export of agriculture products. It is under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So these 4 or 5 agencies, these are very, very important. Questions from these are asked generally in exam. So APEDA was established in 1986. Then MPEDA. MPEDA is similar to APEDA. Here in the place of agriculture, we have Marine Products Export Development Authority. So this MPEDA was established on 1972. Its headquarters are in Kochi. So in case of MPEDA, headquarters are important. Then FCI. So FCI is Food Corporation of India. So it is run by state governments, respective state governments, and it is body under Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. It was established in 14th January 1965. So year of establishment is important in case of FCI. For CCI, Cotton Corporation of India, it is agency for procurement of cotton in India, and it was established in 1970 with its headquarters in Mumbai. So headquarters is important in case of CCI. Then Directorate of Women in Agriculture, it is in Bhubaneswar, Odisha. This Directorate of Women in Agriculture is important. Question might be asked from this DWAR. Then types of crops. There are few terms which are very, very important since these kind of terms were asked in the NABARD phase 2 exam of last year. We will discuss them one by one. First one is LA crops. So what are LA crops? LA crops are also known as hedgerow crops or hedgerow intercrops. So in this case, it is a case of intercropping in which leguminous trees or a row of trees is grown in between crops. So you can say it is agroforestry kind of a thing in which cropping is done in between rows of trees. So in a symbiotic manner in which both are benefited. So in this case, generally sweet potato, black gram or turmeric, ginger, etc. is grown with the trees like eucalyptus, subabul and cassia. So this kind of farming is alley cropping. Then augment crops. So these crops are grown to supplement the yield of main crops like Japanese mustard with barseem. So in this case, the main crop is benefited with the second crop. And also we get an additional benefit or additional profit from the growing second crop. Then augmenting means simply supplementing. Then avenue crops. These crops are grown around the avenues or roads or fences as roads and fences for good looks and additional income. These are like peas and pea and glyceridia. Then catch crops or contingent crops. So these are the short terms and fast growing crops. In case our main crop is failed in between the season, we can grow these kind of crops which are second crops, and these crops grow fast and give us a certain minimal income which will save our total loss or which can save our total loss. Such kind of crops are linseed, toria, udat, moong, cowpea, etc. Then cover crops. So cover crops are crops with high foliage and strong root system, means save soil from erosion. These can save the loss of water from soil through their expanded roots. Then fouling crops. Such crops there are some crops which allow heavy infestation of weed. Like when we grow direct seeded upland rice, there's huge attack of weeds, or weed growth is very high. Such crops are known as fouling crops. These crops generally cause losses to farmers. Then lay crops. So these crops are combination of crops which are grown to for grazing and harvesting for immediate or future feeding of livestock. Then like Barsim and mustard, lay crops are generally for livestock. These are for current harvest or for silage making or later use for livestock. Then smoother crops. So smoother crops are special crops which are grown to suppress weeds. So these crops grow so fast and so high with their large foliage or dense foliage, these can suppress weeds since they have a quick growing ability. Examples are buckwheat, mustard and cowpea. Then there are some nurse crops. So these nourish other crops by providing proper shade and environment to grow. Then there are inflorescence and fruit types of some major crops. These things are also important. One or two questions sometimes are asked in any kind of agriculture exam from these things. The most important of these are rice and wheat. So you must know that in case of wheat, the inflorescence is known as spike or spikelet, and in case of rice, it is known as panicle. For banana, it is spadix. Female inflorescence of maize is known as silk, and male inflorescence is known as tassel. For sugarcane, it is arrow. In fruit types, for all the cereals and grasses, fruit is caryopsis. Then for groundnut is lomentum. For tomato, grape, brinjal, chili, papaya, it is berry. For citrus, it is hesperdium. For pomegranate, it is balusta. And for cucurbits, it is pipo. The fruit of cucurbits is known as pipo. Then some research stations, national and international, related to some crops. The most important ones or the research stations related to the major crops of India. The first one is for rice. It is International Rice Research Institute. It is in Los Banos, Philippines. And for India or national is Central Rice Research Institute, which is in Cuttack, Odisha. For wheat, it is CIMMYT. So CIMMYT in general means International Research Center for Maize and Wheat Development. And it is located in Mexico. ICARDA is an institute for dryland agriculture. It is located in Syria. Directorate of Wheat Research and Indian Institute of Wheat and Barley Research, both are in Karnal. Karnal is in Haryana. Indian Institute of Maize Research is in Delhi. For sorghum, Directorate of Sorghum Research is in Hyderabad. For millets, Indian Institute of Millet Research, it is in Hyderabad. This is important. For pulses, it is Indian Institute of Pulse Research, it is in Kanpur. For oil seeds, Indian Institute of Oil Seed Research is in Hyderabad. For rapeseed and mustard, it is in Bharatpur. This one is again very important. For cotton, Central Institute of Cotton Research is in Nagpur. And then Central Institute of Research in Cotton Technology is in Mumbai. So both are in Maharashtra. For jute, it is CRIJAF. Central Research Institute for Jute and Allied Fibers, it is in Barakpur, West Bengal. For sugarcane, there are two important institutes, Indian Institute of Sugarcane Research in Lucknow and Sugarcane Breeding Institute in Coimbatore. So both are important. For fodders, it is IGFRI. Indian Grass and Forage Research Institute, it is in Jhansi, Uttar Pradesh. For tobacco, it is CTRS, Central Tobacco Research Institute, Hyderabad. It is in Rajahmundry, Hyderabad. Let's move ahead. This is about per capita per day availability of some major crops or some major things in India. For rice, it is 190 grams per day. So for every individual, around 190 gram of rice is available in India per day. For wheat, it is almost similar, 192 grams. Overall total cereal is 451. For gram, it is 17.3 grams of gram per day per person. For pulses, it is 54.4. For food grains total, it is 506, and for milk, it is 394 grams per person per day. So that was per capita availability. And the last thing for this video is the processing, hulling, milling percentage of crops. So out of the rough crop or the raw crop of the field, what is the actual amount extracted, actual useful amount extracted from that particular crop. So, in case of rice, from paddy, 2/3 of rice is extracted after hulling. Then, from groundnut, from the nut, we get 70% of kernels. Like if we have 100 kg of nuts, we get 70 kg kernels. And from these kernels, from every 100 kg kernel, we get 28 kg oil or 28% oil. From kernels, we get 28% oil in case of groundnut. And from shell or from nuts in shell, we get 70% of kernel in case of groundnut. From sesamum, we get 40% oil. From rapeseed mustard, we get 33% oil. From coconut, we get 62% oil. Sugar, for every 100 kg of cane's crust, we get around 11.5 kg of jaggery or gur. 11.5% jaggery is extracted from cane's crust. Then crystal sugar, the sugar which is table sugar, used mostly. So from every 100 kg of cane's crust, 10.2 kg of sugar is produced. So that was all about this video. If you are interested in NABARD Phase 2 Egg Online course, you can check our website. See you soon in the upcoming videos. Thank you very much for watching.